The 2016 presidential election has been unique, to say the least. Outsiders in both the left and the right have gained serious popularity. Meanwhile, establishment candidates have been waning in popularity. It seems that we would have a Donald Trump versus Hillary Clinton race this fall. Nobody can predict what will happen in this election cycle, but one thing is for certain. The election seems to be more of a reality TV show than a presidential campaign. Media coverage is ratings-oriented, with more entertaining sound bites than legitimate journalism. This is why John, Max, and myself have set out to uncover the reality behind this year's political election. Seems we have not found what we were looking for in the Chick-fil-A playpen. Maybe Max did. I'm not sure about that. Anyways, we'll venture off somewhere else, see what we find. Hope we get something good. Stay tuned.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart.
Hi, this is Max. I'm a volunteer with Hillary for New Jersey. How are you? Hi, this is Max. I'm a volunteer with Hillary for New Jersey. How are you today? Hi, I'm calling to see if you'll be voting for Hillary Clinton in the primary election. That's great. Thank you for being a voter for Hillary. Can we count on you to volunteer to help us make sure Democrats vote for Hillary? Okay, thank you so much. Have a great day. No, have a great day. All right, bye. Hi, this is Max. I'm a volunteer with Hillary from New Jersey. How are you today? That was rude. He goes, I'll tell you how good. Hangs up. I'm calling to see if you will be voting for Hillary Clinton in the primary election.
What was that? This is Dan, I'm calling from Hillary Clinton's campaign. This is Dan, I'm calling from Hillary Clinton's campaign. How are you?
That would be a
head. So I understand that you're a committed Hillary supporter. Oh, wonderful. Well, I actually wanted to invite you to an event.
This is Mike, I'm a volunteer with Hillary from New Jersey. How are you tonight?
The irony not lost on
I'm just
that
calling to
Mike
see if you will be voting for Hillary in the upcoming primary election.
Is making phone calls for Hillary Clinton.
Okay.
I'm here, Hillary Clinton phone bank, Melbourne, New Jersey, and we're just talking to an official campaign worker. Give your name.
Hey, my name's Michelle.
Michelle, why do you feel like you should put in time to Hillary Clinton? I know a lot of people here are volunteering, so like, what about the campaign drew you to Hillary, I guess is my question.
Yeah, well, I think that Hillary is the most qualified person in this campaign cycle running for president. I think that she has some great foreign policy experience, which I think our country really needs. She was there for a lot of the major foreign policy decisions that happened during the last administration. And she's a fighter for women's rights and immigration reform and a lot of things that I'm really passionate about personally.
Many people, Donald Trump included, have been kind of preying on Bill Clinton. How do you feel? Do you think it's right that a presidential candidate is judged based on their spouse?
I think that, I mean, I love Hillary Clinton, right, and I'm voting and I'm working for Hillary, and so I'm not really concerned about anybody else. But I do think that it's important that we remember that, like, you know, presidential candidates have a personal life and have, like, spouse and children, and it's important to respect them and just be respectful of that. So I don't think that it's good for people to be critical of politicians' personal lives, but you know, I guess it comes with the package of running for president.
Okay, and lastly, how dangerous would a Donald Trump presidency be?
I think very dangerous.
Would our Klondike bar cop it from the Hillary campaign?
What you in there, Johnny boy, Maxi?
They were very strict about taking food. She at the Bernie rally, they offered food. That's the difference mm-hmm. between democratic socialism and and Democrats. So, thoughts on the Hillary phone bank?
Turn right onto Springfield Avenue and turn right.
So, thoughts on the Hillary phone bank? You know, I can see, I mean, it was boring. It's very Hillary rally.
Turn right, then continue on Meisel Avenue.
No real inspiration there. I mean, Hillary felt like a harrowing depression and boredom wash over my body the second I talked to those people. Hello, everybody. Max Lenz reporting live, Brightwood Park, Westfield, New Jersey. We're here, Bernie 16. We're knocking on doors. It's grassroots reporting. I'm here with John Butler, my cameraman. I'm here with Bango Unchained, Mike Bangs, the legend. We're here. We're going to get some answers. We're going to talk about the issues. But the real reason we're here, Tom heard some rumblings that he got some donuts. And what kind of socialist rally would it be if there would not be a redistribution of donuts into my stomach? Let's go.
Yeah.
So I'm here with Tom for Bernie 2016. We're canvassing the local neighborhood. And we're just going to ask a couple questions about Bernie Sanders' campaign.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for having me.
So, what do you feel like is, when people say kind of that the election is over mm-hmm. because we're nearing and Hillary has a lot of the delegates, we kind of have to pool as Democrats to go to Hillary, what would be your response to that?
My response would be that a lot of states have gone and she's ahead, but Bernie's really leading in the polls against Donald Trump, so he'll be the strongest candidate. Also, he's doing pretty well. He's gaining momentum. So I believe in 2008, when Hillary was going against Obama, she didn't drop out until the very end. So yes, they need to unite at a point, but let's go until July.
And just to kind of wrap it up, why do you feel this kind of conviction to canvass for Bernie? And it's like a rainy day outside. It's not the nicest day. It's a Sunday. You probably could be doing other things. So why do you feel that you need to canvass for Bernie just on a personal level?
Mm-hmm. One thing that I really speaks to me is when I heard him talk in the debate, he really said he was going to raise the minimum wage. So I think that's the key point that I feel like could really help a lot of mm-hmm. working people, a lot of my friends, a lot of my coworkers. So that's really the one that speaks to me, and why he's inspired me so much is it's just great to see someone who's so willing to be outspoken and really talk about the major issues.
Okay.
So.
Thank you, Tom, for...
Yeah, thank you very much. Good luck.
I am here with Bango Unchained, the realist. It's our first house. It took us 2 hours, but we're doing it. We're out here for the people. Let's go.
Another option right now.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
House number 2, registered Democrat. We're here. I hear she's a Bernie supporter. Let's go check out this bumper sticker that's on her car. I knew she was a Bernie supporter. Let's go see. We're here for the people.
As I went walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway.
How is somebody this rich a supporter of Bernie Sanders?
I saw below me that golden valley.
We're Democrats.
This land was made for you and me.
Hi. My name is Max Lenz. I'm volunteering for Bernie 2016. Is Michelle home?
Yeah, she's around. What's up with the camera, bud?
Well, we're just videotaping because we're new and they just want us to videotape the interactions. Is that okay with you?
No.
Bernie Sanders has seen an astronomical rise in his polling numbers since the beginning of his campaign. In the Iowa caucuses, Sanders won 84% of the vote of Democrats aged 17 to 29. He won voters aged 30 to 44 by a 21% margin. At this point, everyone is predicting a Trump-Hillary race this fall, but Bernie Sanders' rise in popularity has proven one thing to America. A candidate's charisma and likability is just as important as their qualification and experience.
Max Lenz here. Driving to the Donald Trump rally, Mike Bangs. Driving. What a guy. Put your hands down. Just focus on the road. Heading to a Trump rally, Lawrenceville, New Jersey. Gonna try to catch the protesters. No Popeyes this time. Stay tuned, folks. Gonna be calling him president in November. Donald. He's gonna be president. We're going to his rally right now. I'm here, Lawrenceville, New Jersey. We're at the Trump rally. Protesters on this side, Trump on that. I wanted to blend in with the Trump supporters, but I wasn't sure what they wore normally, so I just Googled what a member of the Westboro Baptist Church would wear at a party, and this is what I came up with, so let's hope I blend in. Make America great again.
Excuse me, is this the Nickelback concert?
Love your boots, brother. Booyah! Gators. Yes, sir. What's that? Boom. There we go.
Yeah, my grandpa used to sell these. Oh, nice. He gave me the hookup. Yeah.
Donald Trump played the system that was created and is corrupt by the politicians.
I think I can just move the bathroom. What do you think about that?
I think it's completely ridiculous. I think it's completely ridiculous. I think people have lost their fucking common sense.
Yeah.
No, excuse my language.
No.
But what happened? People lose their minds? I don't understand. It used to be cut and clear.
You're communist! Paid for that megaphone with my tax dollars.
I didn't even think of that. I have a megaphone.
So people are able to go into the Trump fundraising.
Don't Trump! Here with Mr. Trump. Mr. Trump. What do you have to say about people that say that you are instilling hate in voters?
I don't hate anybody.
Nobody.
I don't even hate myself.
Why are your hands so small, Mr. Trump?
You know what they say about men that have small hands? All I could say is, don't vote for me, vote for Bernie, because I will screw you.
Which one do you want, this one?
So, Donald Trump, hateful man. What's one example of a thing he said?
I don't know. Your mother's whore said it personally to me.
Did he?
Yeah.
He said it personally to you?
Personally.
When was that?
I was there.
After he fucked my horrible mother. There you go. You guys are obviously for Trump, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, you're smart.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
What's
like
your...
That's really respectful of the flag. Wearing it in shorts.
Yeah.
It's really not.
What's your main...
I'm done with you. I don't like your face.
Okay, thank you.
Woo! Yeah. Oh man.
She like my thing.
Donald Trump, build that wall.
Get out of here.
Build that wall.
Get out of here.
Donald Trump.
Think he's supporting the wall on the red card.
Fuck out of here.
In actuality, his ignorance is the bag. I think it might be a tactic.
What flavor is that?
Strawberry milkshake. Yeah, we should get the fuck out of here, though. Like,
hey, man,
that's
kind of
not cool.
Bro.
We're not going over here.
So we're just going over there.
I didn't get punched. Good day.
While out on the campaign trail, John, Max, and myself learned many different things about this year's election cycle. We talked to many informed activists along the way, but through talking with everyday Americans, we were truly able to uncover the reality behind the 2016 presidential election.
You're great again. Yeah. Are you for Trump or no? Are you for Trump or Hillary?
Nobody.
Nobody? You're not going to vote? Why not?
I don't like both of them.
You don't like either of them? Okay. I like the mustache, though. Beautiful. I'm Max, by the way.
So I'm here at Popeyes. What do you think about this year's presidential election?
Well, to be honest, it's a very hard, it's a tough situation. For example, it's like going back to World War II, during the times. You know, I'm
Thanks.
Just being honest.
He just made that face. I'm sorry. Thanks. Compose yourself.
Which is true, because,
okay,
you know,
so,
So
basically it looks like we're having Trump Clinton, right?
Right.
So what do you think is, like, the best option?
To be honest, none of them. None of them.
Yeah. So do you think you'll vote?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Very well done.
Despite all the hype surrounding this year's political race, the reality we observed is that the everyday American is uninterested and uninformed. It will certainly be a choice between the lesser of two evils for the majority of Americans in the voting booths this November. It seems we are. Trump is delusional, Hillary is robotic, and Bernie is naive. So wake me up.